If you're new to YouTube, welcome to the club. Start by heading to youtube.com and up the top right, click sign in. Next, if you don't already have a Gmail account, head down to create account. Then choose for work or my business. Next, you'll want to get a Gmail address, which is completely free. Put in your name and click next, followed by your birthday and gender. If you've already got an existing email attached to your Google account, it will show up here. So you can either use that or click get a Gmail address instead. Next, choose create your own Gmail address and type in whichever email address you want. Then click next to see if it's available. Add in your password and click next. Then enter another email as a recovery email if you ever need to recover this account. Keep clicking next until you get to the privacy and terms page, which you can read over, and then click agree. So now that you've made an account, it's now time to make your channel. Head up to the top right and click the red circle, then create a channel. Now you can give your channel a name and a handle. The difference between channel name and channel handle is that the name shows up as the name of your channel when people visit it and underneath your videos when people discover them on the YouTube homepage. Whereas the handle is the unique handle that shows up underneath videos when you comment in the comments section. It will show up as @ and then your handle name. It's also the URL that people type in as youtube.com/@ and then your channel handle. So try not to make it too long and complicated so people can actually remember it. The name can be literally anything you want, and the handle can be anything that is uniquely available. So if someone else already has the handle, unfortunately you'll have to think of something else. Don't worry, neither of these choices is permanent. You can always change them in the future if you need to. Next, you'll want to add a profile picture. So if you click this button here, you'll now be able to add either an image template here from the library or upload one directly from your computer. If you have a nice headshot of yourself, I would strongly recommend that. Then click and drag the corners to resize the circle and move your image around so it's nice and centered. That looks good. And finally, create channel. And here we have our sparkling brand new YouTube channel. Now it's time to change a few important settings underneath the hood. Head up to your profile picture in the top right, click it, and then YouTube Studio. Next, head down to settings, then channel, which is the second option, and feature eligibility. Now this step is really important because this is what is going to allow us to upload videos longer than 15 minutes and add custom thumbnails. To do so, choose the drop-down under intermediate features, and to do this you'll have to verify your phone number, so click the black button here, then add in your number so YouTube can send you a verification code. Once you get it, enter it in and click submit. Next, we need to set some important upload defaults for every time we upload a new video. To do that, within YouTube Studio, head to Settings and then Upload Defaults. And here we have what is essentially a template for what will show up every time you upload a new video. So you could add a title and description here, although chances are those things are going to be different every time. However, one thing you will want to change is your visibility. I'd recommend changing it from public to unlisted, which means every time you publish a video, you'll allow yourself a bit of time for the video to fully process and improve quality, as well as adding a description and a title and a thumbnail and so on. It takes a bit of time to do those things, and you don't want the pressure of having your video posted immediately without tweaking those things first. Then if you want to add default tags to every video, you can add them in here. While we're here, you might want to head over to advanced settings. And if you're in a country where the native language is something other than English, you can choose that in this drop-down menu, and this will help you to process the captions of your video faster in your native language. Underneath that is comment moderation. Firstly, you can turn comments off if you don't want anyone commenting on your videos, which I don't recommend because it's good to have a bit of feedback and interaction from your audience. But an option in between the two is moderating with either basic, strict, or hold all filters. I'd recommend choosing basic, which will keep a lot of trolls out if they use swear words and insulting language. But if you find this to be an issue, you can always come back and change it to strict or hold all. Next, you want to head back to the channel section, and you're welcome to add your country of residence, just so YouTube knows where you're located. And then under advanced settings, you want to tell YouTube whether your channel is made for kids or not. Otherwise, it's going to ask you every single time you upload a new video. So this is another upload default. My channel is not aimed at kids, so I'm going to choose no. If yours is, you can choose yes. But again, this is something I'd recommend setting up front so you don't have to do it hundreds of times over. The final setting you'll want to know is here under permissions. And this is where we can add more people to the account if you want someone to help manage or moderate your channel. So if you click invite here on the right hand side, you can add a new user to your account and give them access to either manage, edit just the subtitles, or just be a viewer that can't change anything. This is a feature I use all the time since the automatic YouTube captions aren't always 100% correct. So I'll get an assistant to come in, correct the captions and save them. So now that we've set a couple of upload defaults, go ahead and click save. Now you are so close to uploading your very first video. If you're stuck for ideas, feel free to download my 100 Viral Video Ideas ebook completely for free, which is filled with 100 high-performing templates that you can copy-paste. Before you post a video, though, there are some essential branding elements you may want to add to your channel to make it look prettier. So here in YouTube Studio, if you head to the left-hand side and click Customization, this is where we can edit some key design points of our channel, starting with the banner, which you can upload here. Just keep in mind that YouTube banners need to look good on multiple devices, including TVs, phones, tablets, and computers. Therefore, you'll need to orient most of the design, especially the text, towards the center. Here I'm using a template in Canva. I found Canva to be a pretty good resource for these templates. Now here is where you can also change your profile picture, your YouTube name, and your handle in the future if you ever change your mind and want something different. Next, you can give your channel a description. I'd recommend keeping it short and sweet and focusing on what your channel offers to the viewer and not overly talking about yourself and all your accomplishments. Underneath that, you can add a couple of links if you wanted to include some other social media profiles or your website on your channel's homepage. You can add an email address here if you want people to be able to contact you. Just keep in mind, if you've got a lot of people watching your videos, you may not want to give away your personal email. Instead, use a business email or have an email dedicated solely to your YouTube account. Then finally, right down the bottom, you can add a watermark to your videos. This shows up in the right-hand corner whenever your videos play and essentially acts as a subscribe button. When you're happy with all these settings, go ahead and click publish. Now from here, if you head up to the earn screen, this is where you can track your progress on the journey to becoming a monetized YouTube creator, which as of right now is 1,000 YouTube subscribers and either 4,000 hours of watch time in the last year or 10 million shorts views in the last 90 days. You can ask YouTube to email you once you've reached these milestones. And I'd also recommend turning on two-step verification to make the monetization process smoother. Now, as for everything else here on the left-hand side in YouTube Studio, this is going to rely on you uploading videos for metrics to start coming in. So once you've uploaded videos, they'll appear here. Once you start getting views, all of your data will show up here in analytics. In community, this is where you'll find information about your community, including comments and your top subscribers, which means now it's over to you to go ahead and make your first video. Again, feel free to download my 100 Viral Video Ideas ebook completely for free down below, as well as my top 10 ways to make money on YouTube, where I share the top 10 ways that I've been able to monetize my YouTube channel to 7 figures over the past 10 years. And in it, I share all of the top monetization secrets you need to know. And if you are making a YouTube channel with the aim of monetizing it and building a business, in this video here, I'll share my top 3 monetization sources that helped me scale my YouTube channel the fastest and how you can get started doing the same for yourself.